All right, so in this video, we're going to talk about reverse pyramid training versus straight sets. So these are three of the most popular training mechanisms and styles that you will see in most training routines. And really, pyramid training is the one most people utilize due to bodybuilding routines, fitness influencers. And if you guys have been following the Polarity Fitness content for any length of time, and I know a lot of you guys are following my program, you know that I'm a big fan of reverse pyramid training and straight sets. And we're going to, in this video, compare the three and talk about why. We're going to compare them and talk about which is really the best for building a physique as a natural. So really, pyramid training is a great example of how not to train. And this is actually very, very simple, guys. This whole comparison, it's very, very simple for a few different reasons. So ultimately, the primary principle that's going to allow you to build an incredible physique as a natural is getting strong at your big basic lifts. This is the only thing that matters. You don't need fucking periodization. You don't need all this complicated bullshit. Get strong at your big basic compound lifts, and you're going to look good, and you're going to be jacked. It's as simple as that. Don't let anyone complicate that for you. The fundamental problem, and really, to build strength, which is the primary goal of your training, you need to lift heavy when you are fresh. So every workout is going to look like this. This is the beginning of the workout. This is when you're strongest and freshest. Here's the end of the workout. This is when you're going to be the most fatigued and have the least energy. And what pyramid training does is it starts with the work that you should be doing here, up here at the beginning. So if you guys don't know what pyramid training is, it's basically where you start light for a high number of reps and gradually increase the weight and decrease the reps. So a set rep scheme could look like 12, 10, 8, 6. So by the time you hit that heavy set, heavy, you're already fatigued. And that is the fundamental problem with pyramid training. That is the only reason why it's so shit. Because by the time you hit the set that's actually going to stimulate any meaningful muscle growth and strength gains, you're already fatigued. So it's not actually heavy. You're not actually stimulating any muscle growth because it's not truly heavy. It just feels heavy because you're tired. So that's an absolute dog shit way to train. And that's why it works for drug-free lifters, but not natural lifters. It just doesn't work. So really, you want to flip the script. And this is where reverse pyramid training comes into play. You always want to start heavy, lift heavy when you're fresh, push for personal records. Because if you lift heavy when you're already fatigued and weak, you're not really making any strength gains. And strength gains are the primary driver of muscle growth. So lift heavy when you're fresh, and then slowly as your energy decreases throughout the workout, then you can do lighter work. You don't want to do it the other way around. You always want to start heavy and then finish light. That's a great recipe for results as a natural lifter. Always lift heavy with your big compound lifts at the beginning of the workout. Push for strength gains, push to get stronger, and then at the end of the workout, you can do lighter work. That's where straight sets come into play. So I like to use reverse pyramid training combined with straight sets, because you can't use reverse pyramid training for every exercise, because it's very strenuous, it's very taxing, and it's the same thing as I just talked about. You're not going to use reverse pyramid training when you're down here in your workout, because it's just that's going to be a recipe for shitty results and injuries. So always just use reverse pyramid training for the first one to two exercises of your routine, the big key compound lifts, which should always be at the beginning of your workout. And then for the smaller movements, for the more isolation movements, you can use straight sets, because straight sets are a great way to get an extra volume. The problem with using straight sets as a primary training mechanism is that really, if you're doing, let's say, three sets of 6 to 8 and you're using the same weight for every set, during that first set, you consciously know you have to do more sets. So you're not actually unleashing all that you have in that first set, because you know consciously or subconsciously that you're gonna have to do more sets with this same weight, so you have to reserve some energy. So you're not actually pushing as hard as you could be. And that's the thing with reverse pyramid training. Since you're starting with a heavy set and then you're doing progressively lighter sets and getting more reps, there's a nice mental benefit, and you know that that first heavy set is all you have to do before you can go lighter. So that first heavy set is where you're gonna push really, really hard, push for strength gains, and you know you just have to do it once. So your mind knows, okay, I just gotta do this once, I'm gonna give it my all. Straight sets is the opposite, because you know you have to do that same weight again. So you're not going to push quite as hard as you could be, and you're not going to stimulate as much muscle and strength gains as a result. That's why you should use reverse pyramid training at the beginning, where you're going to be strongest and freshest and stimulate the most amount of muscle with the heaviest weight and push for personal records. Then as you get more tired, you're going to use straight sets just to get an extra volume, because it works well for accumulating volume. Because as I said, you're not unleashing everything into every set, so you can do more of it. With reverse pyramid training, it's very taxing, so you can't do as much volume. You know, I just do 2 to 3 sets when I use reverse pyramid training, because it's very, very intense. So with straight sets, you can do more of it and you can get in a bit more volume. So straight sets are great to use for smaller exercises. I use them for rows, ab work, neck work, like curls, lateral raises, rear delts, movements like that. Any movement that's not my big key compound lift is done with straight sets. So that's really the most effective way to train. It's just that simple. Always lift heavy when you're fresh using the reverse pyramid style. And then as your energy tapers, you want to transition over into straight sets. This actually has a lot to do with the quality of the muscle that you gain as well, funny enough. So there are really two types of muscle growth that you can acquire. There's myofibrillar growth and then there's sarcoplasmic growth. Myofibrillar growth is the growth of the contractile proteins of the muscle, which is responsible for force output, and it's really that dense and hard muscle growth that lasts long. And that is built with heavy lifting on the big compound lifts and long rest periods and training in a more low to moderate rep range. Sarcoplasmic hypertrophy is built with really that pyramid style of training where you lift light weights and you just pump high reps and blood into the muscle and you don't rest very long in between sets. So the beautiful thing about this, the underlying secret to this idea I was talking about where you start heavy and finish light is that in that first set, when you're training with max intensity, you're stimulating maximum muscle fiber recruitment. So that's why with reverse pyramid training, when you do that heavy set, then you drop the weight and go for that lighter set feels like nothing because you're using a lot more muscle mass than if you would have started with that lighter set. If you would have started with that lighter set, it would have felt tough, but it doesn't feel tough because you lifted very heavy before that. So the reason being is because you're using more muscle than you would have if you started with it. So this actually creates a higher quality workout and a higher quality of muscle growth because you're not just using those maximum muscle fibers that you recruited in the first set. They're still stimulated for the rest of the workout. So throughout the rest of the workout, you're going to be using more muscle, even with the lighter work, than if you had started just with light work. That's where the high quality of this training lies. It's that first set, you're recruiting all these muscle fibers, and then throughout the rest of the workout, you're still using those muscle fibers for the lighter work. So the lighter work is therefore more effective, if that makes sense. So that's one of the underlying keys to this training style, where you start heavy, finish light. This is how you train as a natural, guys. This is very, very simple. Always start heavy, push for personal records at the beginning using the reverse pyramid style, and then slowly you're going to taper into straight sets to get in a bit more volume. So that's really it for this video, guys. It's very, very simple. Stay away from pyramid training. That stuff's dog shit. Leave that to the drug users, the bodybuilders, the bullshit fitness influencers. This is real drug-free training. So if you guys enjoyed this video, drop a like, subscribe, of course, if you haven't already, and leave a comment, let me know what you thought, and as well, pick up my free muscle building checklist. So it's a free natural muscle building checklist, has 13 fundamental steps that you need to make sure you're hitting on or else you're not making results as a natural lifter. So treat it as a self-assessment to ensure that you're doing everything you need to be doing to maximize your results as a drug-free lifter. Make sure you pick that up, make sure you're hitting on those fundamental steps, and we'll talk soon. Peace.